Want to know how to record amazing tutorials, including this very one you're watching right now? You're in luck. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodi, and today I'm gonna show you a really great option for screen recording. So if you're a creator, entrepreneur, maybe a freelancer or a consultant, you're gonna need to know how to record amazing tutorials. I'm constantly recording my screen for these very YouTube videos that you watch, which are often tutorial based. I record my screen when I'm creating product demos, and I recently just did a course and it's all screen recorded. And up until recently, I'd been using the same screen recording software since 2011, but I find it was getting a little bit too cumbersome, especially when I have so many projects on the go or so many different recordings within one project. Enter Tela, an amazing webcam and screen recording app. And Tela is also the sponsor of today's video, which means you're getting a special lifetime discount code. Thanks, Tela. All right, let's dive into what Tela is and how to use it. Tela is an all-in-one screen recorder that is so easy and intuitive to use. It allows you to create high-quality videos with basically zero editing skills. So there is a Tela Chrome extension. There is an app for Mac where it allows you to record up to 4K. And there's also web access at tela.tv where you can access all your videos. So no matter how you record, whether that's via the Chrome extension or the dedicated app, your video files will be stored at tela.tv. So let's walk through some of these awesome features and why I think Tela could be a game changer for you. To start a new tutorial, you're gonna click on New Video in the top left, and this will bring up some options of what we wanna capture. So if you wanna do one quick recording, you can just click on Quick, and then you'd be able to just do one quick thing in one go. But Multi allows you to record multiple clips and place them all along your timeline in order to edit them together into one tutorial, which I just love. Now you can also select from already existing clips that you've made, which is really handy if you want to pull in an older clip into a completely new video. Or you can upload a new video file from your computer to get started, which is so great. So I'm going to select Multi to go over some of these awesome features. So we've got our mic and our camera controls, and we also have the ability to share a screen from here. Or under More, you could even present slides from here too, where you could upload from the desktop or from Google Drive directly. Yes, please. You can also show speaker notes here. So this is really handy if you're making a presentation. You would just add those notes right here underneath your camera, just like this. So as these notes say, let's hit the big red button to start recording. So let's pretend that this is my intro clip and say I was introing my presentation just like this to camera. As soon as I am done with this clip, I'll just again hit that big red button to stop recording. And then you're gonna see here that this first clip is generated here for us. So now let's click to add another clip. And this time I'm gonna share the screen so that we can see what we're doing here. So now let's hit record and pretend along with me that we're doing a tutorial here where I need to walk you through this particular screen. Sure, in my Dropbox, you get the idea here. So now here we are on this screen, and I'm just gonna go ahead and stop this recording so that we can see what this looks like. And I'm gonna go through the magic of editing here to show you what my project looks like with multiple clips. So once you've recorded a clip, you have a few options, including some awesome editing features. I like to rename my clips so that I stay organized and I know exactly what this clip is. So trimming a clip is also as easy as pie, if that's a saying. We're gonna select trim. So you can either drag that clip to where you want it to start, or you can just put your mouse where you want maybe a clip to start or end, and you can even split the clip at this point. So if you wanted to trim this section up here a little bit, maybe till after I'm done writing this job description, I'm gonna split it again. I'll select this clip. I'm gonna delete that clip and now it's gone. I've made two separate clips from that one clip. But besides this very simple editing feature, one of my other favorite features is the zoom functionality. So I'm gonna put my mouse, so that red line, where I want the zoom to start. And then I'm gonna click on zoom in the right and add zoom. So instantly it has put a zoom starting right here on my timeline. And we can adjust the scale by using the slider. So if we want it more or less than 200, we could do that here. And then you can adjust the focus point very easily by pulling on the focal point right there. If you want to adjust how long the zoom lasts for, you can do that here by just sliding the zoom to be shorter or longer. You can play it by putting your cursor at the beginning, clicking on play, and it'll show you what that zoom looks like and when it zooms back out. And of course, you can delete a zoom at any time by clicking on it and then clicking delete zoom. Could it be any simpler? And yes, you can add as many zooms as you want. I sound like a broken record, but it is so freaking easy. Seriously, where has this been my whole life? But wait, there's more. You can change the layout of your video or your video pop out at any time. So check this out. You have a bunch of different layouts to choose from here. So your camera can be on one side or the other side, or a circle shape, maybe a square shape, or you could literally just have it on camera only, or you could have it on screen only. And check this out in the portrait section. You can easily create a different layout option for vertical videos like your Reels and your TikToks. How cool is this? And then you can apply your layout to matching clips, or you could just do it for different clips on the timeline. The crop functionality is also easy to use. So maybe you don't like some of the things showing on screen. You're just gonna drag it to cut out what you don't want. And then, of course, you can resize it like this, and you might be wondering, well, there's this background here, what do we do about that? You can easily change the background too. So you have a whole bunch to choose from here. There are a bunch of preset ones, or you could even add your own image. This could be really good for custom branding. And there are even animated ones. So if you like a little bit of movement in the background, perhaps, throughout your video, you would select one of those. You can also pick the shape and style of the border you want on your video. So maybe you want more of like a rounded edge border, you could pick that. And you can have a drop shadow or no drop shadow. You can also mirror your camera after the fact. Check this out. So in this earlier video I did, look at my shirt. You can see that it's backwards. So I'm just gonna hit mirror and bang. It's going to mirror the clip after the fact. How great is this? And yes, I can apply this to all clips as well. All right, back in my other project, you can quickly reorder clips if you want just by dragging and dropping them to the order you want on the timeline. You also have a few other options. If you don't like the clip, you can simply re-record that clip, or you could copy it out to a new or existing video. So I'm gonna click on finish here in order to finish up these edits. And by the way, you can rename your video at any time here too, just by clicking on the name underneath the video and giving it a new name. You can also easily share this video out by clicking on the link symbol. Or if you click on share, you're going to have a few more options like sharing via email, sharing via a GIF, or via an embed code. And by the way, you can also download the video directly. So this download option is actually how I currently use Tela. I download the videos and then I bring them into Final Cut. I add my name keys and my transitions and my music and such. But we need to talk about subtitles for a minute, because up until now, I had been using a third-party service to generate subtitles for me, and then I would copy them over or download them as a certain file and bring them into YouTube, or I would copy my script over and upload that into YouTube, but not anymore. Check this out. Tela generates automatic subtitles, and they are fast. You can edit your subtitles right from here, or you can click on settings, and then you can download the subtitles as an SRT file right from here. You can also simply just copy them from here too, and then paste them where you need them. OMG, this is a massive time saver. If you click in the view settings on the right, you can decide whether or not you want to enable captions by default, enable comments, show the view count, or allow downloads on your video. And underneath the video, you can also add a button. So if you want to link people to your website, maybe your YouTube channel or whatever it is, you can add that here. Here's what I like about sharing a link directly from Tela, and I'm gonna pop back into my workspace for this. So from my workspace, I'm gonna click on all videos to show you something here. You're gonna have all your videos stored here where you can, from this section, duplicate an entire video or click to edit it at any time. Now what's nice about this is that you can edit and update a video at any time, and it's automatically going to be updated on that same link that you had shared. So you don't have to worry about a video being out of date. You would just update it here in Tela and then keep sharing that same link. Something else that is coming soon to Tela are transitions. So this is gonna help make your video look even more polished and smooth. So when you're going from that full screen to a pop-out or vice versa, things are gonna be a lot smoother very soon. There are only a couple of things that I want Tela to add after transitions. One thing that would be nice would be callouts or some type of highlight feature in order to highlight something of importance on screen. And adversely, maybe we don't want to show certain things on the screen. I would absolutely love a blur feature. I need a blur. The last thing I hope Tela gets is the ability to highlight the mouse. I know that a lot of you, when you watch my tutorial videos, you love knowing exactly what point of the screen I'm referencing because of the cursor highlight. All in all, I am so happy with Tela so far. It is a complete game changer, and I could go on and on about it. It's so intuitive and easy to use. There's really no learning curve. You can just jump in and start making awesome tutorial videos. And speaking of which, you know I can never make a sponsored video without giving back to you. So you're getting a 7-day free trial plus 30% off lifetime subscription to Tela using my affiliate link. So I've got that link listed for you in the description below. So seriously, make sure you sign up using that link so you can get 30% off forever. Run. Don't walk. So now I want to hear from you. What screen recording software do you use to record your videos? And what do you think of Tela? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more content just like this. Thanks for watching. See you next time.